Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Today, we're going to use what we've learned about solving rational equations to find solutions to real-life work rate problems. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to solve work rate problems when given a scenario. First, we'll work through an example to help us create a general setup for these types of problems. Next, we'll complete three additional problems using this general setup. Here's our first example. This is the one we're going to use to help us develop our general setup and understand where it's coming from. This scenario says that person A completes a job in 6 hours, and person B completes the same job in 3 hours. How long will it take if they work together? Let's start by thinking about how much each person accomplishes in 1 hour. If person A can complete the job in 6 hours, then in 1 hour, person A would complete 1/6 of the job. 1/6 happens to be the reciprocal of 6. If you forgot about reciprocals, remember you just take a fraction and flip it. And if person B can complete the job in 3 hours, then person B would complete 1/3 of the job in 1 hour, which is the reciprocal of 3. We don't know how much time it takes if they work together yet, so this is going to be our unknown variable, x. And we again use the reciprocal to see what the hourly rate is. Also, together does tend to mean add. So if we add person A's rate and person B's rate together, we'll find out how much of the job they can do in 1 hour. That's where we get our equation. This is the kind of equation we're going to be working with in this lesson. In general, the reciprocal of the first individual A's time and the reciprocal of the second individual B's time add up to be the reciprocal of the total time T. This will be our general setup that we use to help us organize and solve each work rate scenario. Now that we have this set up, let's finish solving the question. If we use the LCM method we learned in a previous lesson, we need to find the least common multiple of the denominators, which are 6, 3, and x. The LCM would be 6x, so we multiply every term by 6x. What will happen is all of the denominators will end up canceling with something from that LCM, and we won't have to deal with fractions anymore. So 1/6 times 6x gives us x. 1/3 times 6x gives us 2x. And 1 over x times 6x gives us 6. And just like that, all the fractions are gone. Finish solving by combining like terms and dividing by 3. Okay, so we got an answer of 2, and we know it's not extraneous because it wouldn't make any denominators equal 0. But what does x equaling 2 mean? Interpreting our answer is probably the most important part of this problem. So what does 2 mean? This means working together, they can complete one job in 2 hours. Person B was the faster worker and can complete the job all alone in 3 hours. So it would make sense if there was another worker to help, the job would get done even faster than that. Our next example says that worker A completes a job in 6 hours, and together, worker A and worker B complete the job in 2.4 hours. How long would it take worker B to complete the job without help? Let's think back to our general setup for this type of equation. We're adding the reciprocals of each individual time to equal our combined rate. The reciprocal of worker A's time here is 1 over 6. And we don't know worker B's time, so the reciprocal of this would be 1 over x, with x representing worker B's time. But we do know that together they complete the job in 2.4 hours. So let's find the reciprocal of 2.4. First, we have to turn it into a fraction. 2.4 is equal to 24/10, which reduces to 12 over 5. And if we flip those numbers, we get 5 over 12. Now that we've set this up together, you can take it from here. You have all the skills you need to solve this, so find that LCM for the denominators and keep going. All done? All right, let's make sure our work matches. The LCM of 6x and 12 is 12x. Multiply every term by 12x and see what's left in each fraction. 1 sixth times 12x is 2x. 1 over x times 12x is 12. And 5 over 12 times 12x is 5x. Then, finish solving by getting all the x's to one side of the equation and dividing. Also, make sure 4 doesn't make a denominator turn into 0 because we wouldn't want to use an extraneous answer. Now remember that understanding what our answer means in this scenario is the most important thing. So, what does 4 mean? It's how fast worker B could complete the job if working alone. It makes sense that it would take 4 hours when working alone when it only takes 2.4 hours with a helper. Here's another example. A hose can fill a kiddie pool with water in 15 minutes. A child is splashing water out of the pool and will empty it in 45 minutes. How long would it take to fill the pool with the child splashing in it? Picture what's happening here. The hose is filling the pool, but the child is taking water back out. Instead of working together, these rates are working against each other. Let's think about how that could change our general setup. The time to fill the pool is 15 minutes, and the reciprocal of this is 1 over 15. That takes care of the first fraction. Let's look at the child splashing. 45 would become 1 over 45, but it's not filling the pool, but taking water back out of the pool. So rather than adding 1 over 45, we have to subtract it here. Then we have our combined rate, with x representing the minutes to fill the pool with the child splashing, which we don't know yet. Now that we have the setup done, let's see if you can finish this problem and interpret the answer on your own. Pause the video here and try it out. Okay, let's finish this together so you can see how you did. The LCM of 15, 45, and x is 45x. So multiply each term by that. Then simplify each fraction, combine like terms, and divide. And 22.5 is not extraneous, so we move on to the most important part. What does 22.5 mean? Well, this would be the amount of time it takes to fill the pool with the child splashing water back out. It makes sense that without the child splashing, it would take 15 minutes, and with the child splashing, it would take a little longer. Here's our last example, and it's a little more difficult than the others, but just keep in mind that general setup and it won't be too tough. This problem says a new assembly line worker is being trained to make children's toys. When they each work alone, the experienced trainer can make a toy 3 minutes faster than the new worker. If they work together, it takes them 2 minutes to make a toy. How long does it take the new worker to make a toy alone? Pause the video and get started setting up the equation for this. If you get stuck, I'll be able to help you, but see what you can do on your own first. We don't know the rate of either employee, but we do have a comparison between them, and we have the total if they work together. So if we use x as the time of the new worker, we could use the reciprocal of this and have 1 over x. Then we could say that the experienced trainer is 3 minutes faster than the new worker. That means his time is 3 less than the new worker. We were also told their total time, so we take the reciprocal of that. Now that we have the equation, pause the video now and solve this equation from here. Also, remember to interpret what your answer means. This LCM is a little longer, but since none of the denominators have any common factors, we just multiply them by each other. This gives us an LCM of 2 times x minus 3 to multiply by. Then we can cancel x in the first numerator and denominator. We can cancel x minus 3 in the second numerator and denominator, and 2 from the third numerator and denominator. Then, distribute through the parentheses, combine like terms, and since we have an x squared term, we need to get this equal to 0 in order to solve it. We want to keep the x squared term positive, so we move everything to the right. Once it's set equal to 0, we can rearrange the size if we want to, and then factor and solve. Now, while neither of these gives us an extraneous solution, one of them doesn't make sense within the scenario. These are the possible answers of the new worker's time to complete the toy, and the experienced trainer takes 3 minutes less. So, if 6 is the answer, and we subtract 3, the experienced trainer can make a toy in 3 minutes. This would be a logical time for the more experienced employee because it would make sense that he would take 3 minutes by himself and only take 2 minutes with a helper. Let's check the time for the experienced employee if the new employee takes 1 minute to make the toy. If we subtract 3 from it this time, we would get that the experienced employee takes negative 2 minutes to make a toy. A negative time wouldn't make sense, so we can eliminate this answer. Now, let's make sure we're answering the question. Do we want to use 6 as our answer, or 3? Well, 6 minutes would be the time for the new worker, and 3 minutes would be the time for the experienced trainer. The question asked us how long it takes the new worker to make a toy. So, we need to use the 6 for our answer. Now you can solve work rate problems. Remember to use the general setup with the reciprocal of the times, and then use the LCM of the denominators to help you solve. See you next time.